Okay, you can open your eyes. This is it, this is now, this is what I've been talking about. Looking out, can't you see forever? Take my hand, just take it in. This is the moment we won't forget. If there ever was a time for a perfect kiss, this is it. Girl, I know that you've been waiting, talking to your friend, wondering if and wondering where and wondering when. I've been waiting too, holding on to this ring, for the right words you say, for the right time and place for me, turn on one knee. This is it, this is now, this is what I've been talking about. Looking out, can't you see forever? Take my hand, just take it in. This is the moment we won't forget. On top of the world, being together. If there ever was a time for a perfect kiss, this is it. This is it. Now you're walking down the aisle, and I can't help but smile. And this is it, and this is now, this is what I've been talking about. Looking out, I can see forever. This is the moment we won't forget. On top of the world, being together. Surrounded by our family and our friends. If there ever was a time for a perfect kiss, this is it. This is it.
Let us pray. Lord God, we come before you on this beautiful December morning to come together to witness the marriage of Robert and Crystal. Lord, the joining of two families to be one. And Lord, I just pray that as we come together today, that our hearts would be filled with joy and excitement for what you have for this couple, what you have for this family. And now, Lord God, as we move into this time of exchanging vows and sharing of rings and speaking of what the gift of love is between a man and wife, Lord God, I pray your blessings and your presence. Lord, we love you. We thank you for this opportunity to be a part of this very special day for Robert and Crystal. Now would you bless it? In your name we pray these things. And everybody said,
amen. Amen.
You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the joining together of Robert and Crystal into a holy estate of matrimony. The sacred relationship of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned marriage by his presence and first miracle at the wedding in Cana of Galilee. The Apostle Paul chose marriage to symbolize the union between Christ and his church, and a holy scripture commends marriage to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given to one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will, for the procreation of children and their nurture of the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but soberly and deliberately and in reverent fear before God. Into this holy union, Robert and Crystal now come to be joined. Our Lord Jesus Christ taught us that at the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Consequently, they are no longer two, but one flesh. You have come to be made husband and wife. Robert, do you now leave your father and mother to establish your home with Crystal? As her husband, to receive her as your wife? To make a home where she will be loved and cared for as long as God grants her life? Crystal, do you now leave your father and mother to establish your own home with Robert as his wife, to receive him as your husband, to make a home where he will be loved and cared for as long as God grants him life? Ernie, do you promise to encourage Robert and Crystal in their marriage, to present an example of love and devotion for them to emulate, and to help them build a strong and stable home for themselves and their family? If so, say I do.
I do.
And now to the congregation and the wedding party. Will all of you witnessing these promises do all in your power to uphold those two persons in their marriage? If so, say I do.
I do.
Who is this giving this woman to be married to this man? We are reminded during this time at weddings that the Lord wrote about what love was. And this morning, I think it's appropriate as we look at this beautiful December morning, how glorious it is with the sunshine and the cool breeze, that we would come today to celebrate the union of Robert and Crystal. And as we do that, I'm reminded of the love that God has prepared for a man and a woman. And I would like to share with you from 1 Corinthians. I can speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices in whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up. Love never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. As we consider the gift of love that God first gave to man, and we look at this definition of what love is, I'm reminded this morning as we come before God together for this union of the beautiful gift that God gave to us through his Son, Jesus Christ, the ultimate gift. And this is Advent season. And how beautiful of a time to come and get married. A time where gifts are abundant. Amen? Mm-hmm. It's a time that we are reminded as the Advent season begins to look back and remember the beautiful gift that God gave to us. And that is his Son. And what does that have to do with marriage? I believe it has to do with everything. Because at this moment, We are seeing a beautiful gift beginning to unwrap before us into the beautiful gift of marriage. And God created man in his own image. And then he said, it is not good for man to be alone. And so he created Eve to be his helpmate, to be his partner, to be his love. And his love has already been created within the two of these that stand before us to be married today. It is also a gift that will extend out. And so we might think, well, what does Christmas have to do with marriage? And why is she talking about Advent? Because I believe Advent speaks of the union of marriage, because it's yet another gift that God has given to us. As we've already heard from the words spoken, Paul even suggested that Christ loved the church as much as a man loves his bride. So yet another gift has been given to us. And we live in a culture that is totally counterculture to marriage these days. But I believe as we see this gift being opened before us and unwrapped, we are going to see great days ahead. As the love between Robert and Crystal flourishes, as it flows over unto the children and the friends, the parents, the community. And what a beautiful gift that God has given to them. This love that will sustain them for a lifetime. Amen? And so as we consider the gift of love, we consider the gift first of Christ coming as a babe during this Christmas season, and the gifts that abound and the things that he provides for us through the gift that God gave his only begotten Son, so that none should perish, but all should have everlasting life. That life includes a gift of love and marriage. So I'm very honored to be able to be here this morning to invite Crystal and Robert to come forward and to be received as a bride and a groom, to let the gift continue to unfold before you, and to allow this gift of love that God has given to us, both man and woman, not just in the gift of salvation, but in the gift of life. Amen? Okay, Robert, I'm going to invite you to take your bride's hands. Okay. I charge you, Robert and Crystal, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love, commitment, and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy home. If the solemn vows which you are about to make are kept without violation, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the whole will of God, remember to keep Jesus Christ as the foundation of your lives and of your family. Your life together will be full of joy, and the home which you are establishing will abide in peace. No other human ties are more tender and more important. No other vows are more sacred than those you now assume today. Robert, Crystal, do you understand these truths? If so, answer, we do. Robert, will you have Crystal to be your wedded wife, to live together in holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto her, so long as you both shall live? Crystal, will you have Robert to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him, so long as you both shall live? Robert, repeat after me. I, Robert.
I, Robert.
Take you, Crystal.
Thank you, Crystal.
You want to look at her.
That's actually right.
You just need to look at her. I, Robert.
I, Robert.
Take you, Crystal.
Thank you, Crystal.
to be my wife, my partner in life, my one true love. I will cherish our union. I promise to love you more each day. I will trust you. I will respect you. Laugh with you and cry with you. Loving you faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles we may face. I give you my hand, my heart, and my love. From this day forward, for as long as we both shall live. Crystal. I, Crystal, take you, Robert, to be my husband, my partner in life, my one true love. I will cherish our union. I promise to love you more each day. I trust you. I respect you. Laugh with you and cry with you. Loving you faithfully through good times and bad, regardless of the obstacles we may face. I give you my hand, my heart, and my love from this day forward for as long as we both shall live. I believe there are rings to be exchanged. Okay, Robert and Crystal, these rings you hold today have no beginning and no ending, which symbolizes that the love between you will never cease. The ring is a symbol of the commitment which binds these two together. There are two rings because there are two people, each to make a contribution to the life of the other and to their new life together. And now, as a token of your love and your deep desire to be forever united in heart and soul, you, Robert, may place the ring on the finger of your bride, Crystal. Robert, repeat after me. I, Robert, give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. And faithfulness to you. Crystal. By the same token, Crystal, you may place the ring on the finger of your groom. Repeat after me. I, Crystal.
I, Crystal.
Give you this ring.
Give you this ring.
You may place it. Sorry. I, Crystal.
I, Crystal.
Give you this ring.
Give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And faithfulness to you.
And faithfulness to you.
Now I just
Husband and wife, together, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Robert, I think this is it. You may kiss your bride. I now present to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Townsend.
Charlie's got a gold watch. It don't seem like a whole lot. After 30 years of travel, up and down the interstate. But Charlie's had a good life, and Charlie's got a good wife. And after tonight, she'll no longer be counting the days. 18 wheels and a dozen roses. and more love. On this 4-day run, a few more songs on the all-night radio, and he'll spend the rest of his life with the one that he loves. Winnebago set out to find America, but do a lot of catching up, a little at a time. With pieces of the old dream, they're gonna like the old thing, doing what they please, leaving every other reason behind.
Refreshments and celebration of today's event of the marriage of Robert and his bride Crystal Townsend. And so we want to invite you to stay with us. There's a small reception out the side to the right of the doors, and the bride and groom will be at the back to greet you. And we do want to be mindful, of course, to mention for wearing of the mask and for keeping distance. We want to be safe, but we do want to celebrate. And so please stay with us to celebrate today. Thank you for coming.
18 wheels and 1,000 roses, 10 more miles on this 4-day ride, a few more songs on the all-night radio.
You made it through, the roof didn't fall in, so we're all good.
Too long.